Welcome back to my Road to Completion Guide for Little Nightmares 2. This is episode 3. Follow me so we can grab a battery to open the gate. Open the vent before the elevator breaks. Grab the flashlight before moving forward. You can turn the flashlight on and off with the circle button. You can find another glitch remain near the wagon in the next area. Follow me to the vending machine. Keep pulling the switch to release soda cans until the trophy pops. Grab one of the soda cans, leave the area, and touch the TV in the next room.
Thank you.
Go past the elevator to find the x-ray room. Pull the switch, grab Six's hand, and enter the x-ray machine to unlock another trophy. If you still don't have the trophy for holding her hand for 6 minutes, now's a good time to get it. Move into the next room and grab the teddy bear hat off the shelf. This action will unlock the half hat trophy. If you don't get the trophy, compare your hat collection to mine so we can figure out which one you're missing. Put on the teddy bear hat, grab the teddy bear, and take the elevator to the incinerator. Throw the teddy bear inside the incinerator and pull the switch to unlock a trophy called Toys Are For Kids. Now grab the key, open the locked door upstairs, and locate the glitched remain in the hallway full of mannequins. Pull the box and dodge the hand to leave the area. Dodge the hand in the next room to reach the battery. Okay. Kill the hand guarding the battery with the sledgehammer, but don't stop hitting it until the trophy pops. The best way to attack the hand is to run away when it jumps, then counter with a quick shot. Take the battery pack to the main lobby and place it inside the outlet near the gate. Pull the switch to turn off the lights. When the area goes dark, the mannequins move, but you can stop them with your flashlight. Grab the cheese near the bed and throw it down the hole in the next room. This action unlocks the objection trophy. Now interact with the glitch remain before leaving the room. Avoid the mannequins by running slightly left and right of the center line on the floor. There will be Roman mannequins around the corner, so be prepared to slow them down with your flashlight. Pull the switch for extra light, move the box in the back left corner, and touch the glitch remain beside the bathtub for the sick kids trophy. Throw a bar of soap to open the gate. Pull the switch to turn off the lights, then bait the mannequin to follow us into this room so we can kill it. Avoid the mannequins using the flashlight and exit the area. Throw the medicine ball to the mannequins to unlock the medicine ball trophy. Pull the switch, grab the battery, and leave the area. Grab the battery and drop it off in the lobby. Grab the corn beside the wheelchair and throw it downstairs. Take the batteries to the outlet beside the elevator. Sometimes six will get the other battery for you, but you may have to get it yourself. throw the corn inside the incinerator, and pull the switch to unlock the popcorn trophy. Kill the hands with the pipe, then help Six remove the wood from the door. This sequence plays out exactly like our encounter with the teacher. Wait for him to look away, then move through cover to avoid detection. Thank you. Grab the block in the back of the room so we can use it to open the gate. Stay under the bed until he leaves the area to stay safe. Grab the bandage hat, get the key, and I'll show you where to find another battery.
Thank you.
drop and grab the switch, then hide under the cart by the door. Once he's distracted, sneak out and get the battery from the other room. Place the battery in the outlet, post up by the gate, and wait for the chase sequence to begin. As soon as the gate opens, you'll need to run, jump, and slide to make it out alive. Bait him into the incinerator, but do not pull the switch. We need to leave the hospital with him alive to unlock a trophy called First Do No Harm and Hospitalized. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. I'll see you in the next one. Be good.